Good morning, students. Hope you to have a great day ahead. So today in this class we are going to discuss about a new lesson from your class. So see the lesson: globe, a model of the earth. So actually, what is meant by globe? So see the definition: globe, it is a model of the earth. So when we are able to see the globe, it is appearing or it is looking like, it is looking like the model or the shape of the earth. So simply in our words we call it as a model of the earth. So if you see the shape of the globe, mostly we are calling it in the shape of spheroid shape. So what is the shape of the earth? Spheroid shape. So one more thing you need to remember here: it is pressed at the poles and bulged in the middle. So when you are able to see any globe, if you see the poles, it is having little press, and if you see in the middle, it is having bulge out. So it is not a perfect sphere, or it is not the perfect round in shape, but we are assuming it is in the shape of spheroid. So mostly in the beginning, I mean before 2000 years, everyone believed that earth is in the shape of flat shape, or earth is in flat shape. But in the year 1400 CE, what is meant by CE? Common era. Everyone believed that earth is not in the shape of flat, earth is in the shape of ball shape. You see, previously everyone believed that earth is in flat shape, but later everyone believed that earth is in the shape of ball. So mostly in the evidence you can see it is in the shape of ball. It is appearing like ball. And if you see in the year 1492, in the year 1492, Columbus, Christopher Columbus, he is from Italy. Italy is a country in European continent. So in the year 1492, Christopher Columbus, he is from Italy. He is an Italian explorer. He thought that earth is in ball shape. So if you see the ball, or if you take any round shape thing, if you move on from one direction, we may come from other direction. He believed the same. He believed that earth is in round shape, and he tried to travel from one direction. His intention in the mind is to discover the new sea route to India. So if you see, there will be here, India will be here. So Italy is on the east direction, but he traveled towards west. I told you before, he believed that earth is in round shape. So if we move on from one direction, we may come from other direction. He believed the same. He traveled to move on to the west direction. Finally, he went for discovering the Caribbean islands, and he went for discovering the America. Who discovered America? Christopher Columbus discovered the sea route to America. And you know very well, who discovered the sea route to India? Vasco da Gama discovered the sea route to India. So you remember something? Christopher Columbus, he believed that earth is in round shape. He believed that if you move from one direction, you may come from other direction. So he traveled towards west direction. He believed that he will come from east direction and discover India. But he stopped at Caribbean islands, and he went for discovering America. So if he continuously go even after the America, he may discover India. But he stopped at the Caribbean islands. Who is he? Christopher Columbus. Christopher Columbus discovered sea route to India. Who discovered sea route to Christopher Columbus discovered sea route to America. Who discovered sea route to India? Vasco da Gama discovered sea route to India. So mostly, if you see the continents, we have four. If you see the oceans, we have five oceans, and we have four major oceans and one minor ocean. So see the major oceans. First one, Pacific Ocean. Second one, Atlantic Ocean. Third one, Indian Ocean. Fourth one, Arctic Ocean. And coming to fifth one, so it is said to be Antarctic Ocean or Southern Ocean.
southern ocean. So mostly we have four major oceans.
They are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean and Arctic Ocean. And another ocean we have, that is Antarctic Ocean. It is also called Southern Ocean. So which is the deepest ocean or which is the longest ocean? Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean in the world. So coming to continents, already we discussed in the last class. We can go for once again. So first continents, we have seven continents. First one Asia, second one Europe, third one Africa, fourth one North America, fifth one South Africa, sixth one Australia. Coming to seventh one, Antarctica. So see once again, we have five oceans: Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean and Antarctic Ocean. But we will discuss mostly about the four major oceans: Pacific, Atlantic, Indian and Arctic. Coming to continents, we have seven continents. First one Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, South America, Australia and Antarctica. So these are the seven continents, and we know very well Asia is said to be the largest continent in the world. Coming to Australia, Australia is said to be the smallest continent in the world. Coming to Africa, Africa is said to be dark continent. Coming to Antarctica, it is said to be frigid continent because most of the area, mostly it is covered with snow throughout the year. So if you see the directions, so mostly we have four directions: north, south, east, west. And we have four hemispheres. Actually, what is meant by hemispheres? Hemi means half, half sphere. So you see, so you see, it is said to be northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere, and this one is said to be southern hemisphere. And coming to this, it is said to be eastern hemisphere. And coming to this, it is said to be western hemisphere. You see, the shaded part is representing the hemisphere. So here the northern part is shaded, so what we call northern hemisphere. Here southern part is shaded, so what we call southern hemisphere. Here eastern part is shaded, so what we call eastern hemisphere. Here western part is shaded, so what we call western hemispheres. So we have the four hemispheres. And coming to this one, so very important thing we need to learn from the lesson, that is longitudes and latitudes. So actually, what is meant by latitudes? The imaginary lines, not the real lines, the imaginary lines which are connecting the east to west direction are called latitudes. So if you see the globe, so it is said to be north, it is said to be south pole, east, west. So we can see these lines, these are the lines which are connecting east and west direction. So what we call these lines as latitudes. What we call latitudes? So equator, very important latitude, that is equator, because it is said to be the longest latitude. So which is the longest latitude? Equator is the longest latitude. It is going to divide the earth into two equal parts, you see. So it is in the center and dividing the earth into two equal parts, two equal halves,
That is called equator. It is the longest latitude. Equator is the longest latitude,
and it is dividing the earth into two equal parts. So coming to longitudes, you see the imaginary lines which are connecting North Pole and South Pole are called longitudes. So you see, these are the lines which are connecting east and west direction. Coming to these are the lines which are connecting North Pole and South Pole. North Pole and South Pole. So what we call the lines which are connecting North Pole and South Pole as longitudes. So we have two main longitudes. First one, 0 degree longitude. It is also called Greenwich line. Very important. So first important longitude, that is 0 degree longitude. It is also called Greenwich line. Coming to second one, 180 degree longitude. It is also called International Date line. So you see, two important longitudes. First one, 0 degree longitude. It is also called Greenwich line. Second one, 180 degree longitude. It is also called International Date line. So these are the two important longitudes, and this is one important latitude. And coming to rotation, if a body is rotating on its own axis, if a body rotates on its own axis, it is called rotation. Suppose I am a body, I am able to rotate myself on my own axis. If you see the fan is able to rotate on its own axis. If you see the top, it is able to rotate on its own axis. So what we call it as rotation. If a body is able to rotate on its own axis, then it is said to be rotation. Best example, fan, top, or the needle in the clock. So those are the best examples of rotation. Coming to revolution, if a body is moving around another body, then it is called revolution. See, previously I told, suppose I am a body, I am able to rotate on my own axis, so it is said to be rotation. I am a body which is said to be in rotation. So if you see, suppose if you take this, it is a body and it is another body. Now this body is able to move around another body, so it is said to be revolution. So about the remaining topics, we will discuss the next one. See here once again, globe. It is a model of the earth. Earth is in spiral shape. Everyone in the beginning assumed that earth is in flat shape. Later everyone believed that earth is in the shape of ball. Mostly in the year 1492, Christopher Columbus, an Italian explorer on the way to discover India, he traveled towards west direction and discovered America. Vasco da Gama, by overcrossing the Europe continent and Africa continent, discovered the sea route to India. Oceans, we have four major oceans: Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and another one is said to be Antarctic Ocean. It is also called Southern Ocean. Continents, we have seven continents: Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, South America, Australia, and Antarctica. So we have the four directions. Mostly we have four directions: North, South, East, West. We have four hemispheres. You can see the shaded part is representing so and so hemisphere. Latitudes, the imaginary lines which are connecting east and west direction are called latitudes. Important latitude, equator. It is dividing the earth into two equal parts. Coming to longitudes, the lines which are connecting North Pole and South Pole are called longitudes. We have two main longitudes: 0 degree longitude. It is also called Greenwich line. 180 degree longitude. It is also called International Date line. Next, so we will discuss more about the longitudes and latitudes.
We will discuss about the scientific reason for making the longitudes and latitudes in the 7th class and 8th class. Next, rotation. If a body rotates on its own axis, we call it as, it is said to be rotation. Revolution. If a body moves around another body, it is said to be revolution. Thank you, students. We will discuss remaining topics in the next class.